John Corzine, of course, was a U.S. senator and the governor of New Jersey, very powerful figure within the Democratic Party. He also used to be the former head of Goldman Sachs. He went to go run MF Global after he lost the governor's race to Chris Christie in New Jersey, and he ran it straight into the ground. Total disaster. In fact, they can't find $1.2 billion of customers' money. He's been going in front of Congress over the last week. Both him, who, of course, the CEO of the company, and then also the chief operating officer, Bradley Abelow, and the chief financial officer, Henry Steenkamp, have all gone in front of Congress and said, golly gee willikers, we don't know where the money went. We don't know anything about it. We can't find it at all. And we certainly didn't give any orders. We did not give any orders that we intended for people to interpret that we should take the client money that they're not supposed to take and gamble with it, right, on European derivatives. So it's funny how the financial geniuses tell us that if we go to fire them, how absolutely necessary they are and what great talents they are and how they deserve millions of dollars in bonuses because of their financial genius. But when it comes to find out, hey, where did the money go or what did you do wrong, all of a sudden they're morons. They're like, what? I didn't know what was going on. $1.2 billion missing? Well, golly gee, I know nothing about that. I'm an idiot. Convenient when they're idiots and convenient when they're geniuses, right? I'm pretty sure which one they actually are. So so they go to Congress and they say, yeah, I don't know what happened, but here's the problem. Terrence Duffy, who's the executive chairman of CME, which is supposed to be regulating, part of the people regulating the company MF Global, says that he has testimony from someone who was on a call who heard. Now, this is, you know, their lawyers will argue is hearsay, but an employee of MF Global that said, yes, John Corzine absolutely knew what we were doing with the client's money and that we had taken from the funds that we were not supposed to take. So that'll be interesting. And the whole time he's weaseling in front of Congress, every time clarifying, I did not intend for any of my orders to have the effect that they had, because his defense will rely on, yes, this was the result of his orders, but as long as he has no intent, he cannot be found criminally responsible. Weasels to the nth degree. Now, what's interesting is that the CFTC, another regulator, had decided that, hey, wait a minute, what MF Global is doing is a little fishy here. They really shouldn't take the client's money that they're not supposed to gamble with and put it in the other direction. Now, they weren't even entirely sure that that was happening, but they thought there's something fishy going on here, so let's pass a rule to make sure that they cannot do that, to make it extra clear, right? So what happens? Intense lobbying. John Corzine, who used to work with Gary Gensler at Goldman Sachs, Gary Gensler now the head of the CFTC, who, by the way, is a good regulator, one of the few good regulators otherwise, but here seems to have made a terrible mistake, if you ask me. It gets lobbied by Corzine. Corzine says, yeah, I went in there several times. Some of our other executives went in there to talk to regulators, but we did not intend for our lobbying to have the effect of the easing up on regulations. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, spare me. So what happens? They choose not to push that rule in. They do not regulate them. Next thing you know, MF Global does that risky gambling with the client's money, loses it. By the way, 5 weeks after they went bankrupt, the CFTC then turns around and goes, yeah, we should have done that rule. Let's do it now. By the way, John Corzine, one of the biggest bundlers for Barack Obama. $500,000 at least of bundled money that has gone to President Obama. In fact, this swindler is the guy that was put on a short list of people to consider when if Tim Geithner resigned as Treasury Secretary, which he was considering doing a little while ago. And I read the articles myself. Before, of course, he got into trouble at MF Global. Well, the genius John Corzine, who was the CEO of Goldman Sachs and a senator, and who happened to give a lot of money to the Obama administration or to his election campaigns, was being considered for our Treasury Secretary. He should be arrested. It is to take the client's money and then lose $1.2 billion and not to tell anybody where it is. That is fraud. And that, in fact, that's outright theft. I did not intend for the theft. What do I know? Now, you're wondering, why would he do it, right? Here's a guy with a lot of money. In fact, when he left Goldman Sachs, he had $350 million that he left the company with. So why take the risk? Well, because the risk actually calculation makes sense if you care about no one else. So let me explain why. Now, some say that he no longer has the $350 million because of the political campaigns that he spent money on, because of the costly divorce that he went through, etc. But if we were to assume, but then, you know, he probably made investments and made more on it as well. So let's just assume for the moment being that he still has the $350 million from Goldman Sachs. Well, he put $50 million of his own money into MF Global. And so a lot of his defenders and the defenders of Wall Street will say, you see that? He had his own money into this thing. So of course he didn't mean it for it to go wrong. But look at this calculation. If you got 350 and you take $50 million out and you put it in MF Global and you lose it all because you took crazy risks, well, you still have $300 million left. So that's not so bad. Remember, the leverage that he took was 30-1. The downside of that is that if you just have a 4% error, the bet goes against you 4%, you're bankrupt. It's a crazy risk to take. But if it goes in your direction, 30-1, a win would mean $50 million, which he's got in the company, would be multiplied by 30 times. Now, this is a slightly simplistic calculation, but it's pretty close. So overall, he would then have $1.5 billion. And if you add the additional 300, it'd be actually $1.8 billion. So he thinks, hey, you know what? I take this crazy risk. If I lose, I still got $300 million in the bank. Yeah, this company that's been around for over 100 years goes bankrupt. The thousands of people who work or are related to this company go out or lose their jobs. But who cares about that? I'm a Wall Street titan. If I win, I got $1.8 billion. And now I'm considered a bigger genius, and I can buy a bigger yacht and 8 Bentleys, and I can even give more campaign donations to whoever I want to fix the regulations in my favor. So why did John Corzine do it? That's why he did it. And of course, when it went wrong, he has got a ton of lawyers to defend him. But everybody else is A, out of a job, and those clients are out of $1.2 billion and are incredibly mad, and they should be.